Come on, you can do better than that. Somebody clap your hands, everybody. Hey! Lord God, we welcome you to this place, Lord. Hallelujah. Here we are, open arms, every heart overcome by your love and freedom. Here we stand, lifted hands unto the Hallelujah. Every day, giving thanks, bringing our everything by your love and freedom. Here we stand, lifted hands to the King. Say, oh, oh,
you are
again. So that's why we dance in the empty. Cause we're doing it all again. Hey, hey, yeah, yeah, yeah. Cause you're doing it all again. Oh, 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 oh. You make the blind man
see.
You make the blind man walk again.
You make the blind man walk again.
You cause the dead
to us.
So that's why we dance in
liberty. That's why we dance in liberty.
But you're doing it.
You're doing it all again.
Doing it again and again and again. Yeah. How many people believe that there's power in the name of Jesus? Can I just go throw just Kelly James worship leader throwback real quick? Come on, I just got it. I requested this one. They weren't even going to turn up the music in. Come on, make it feel good. Come on, everybody, I need you to put your hands together like this. Do it like this. Turn me up in the monitors. Music in the monitors. Track in the monitors. Be shame. Jesus' name. This is where I need you at home, you in the room, to put your hands together like this. We're serving notice on the devil. We're taking everything. We're going into the enemy's camp, and we're going to take back everything that he stole from us. I need some ladies to step up and say, if God, God is mine. I need to hear you say, God is fighting for us, pushing back the darkness. Make them hear you at home. Make them hear you.
In the name of Jesus, enemies defeated, and we were shouting.
That's it. I want to hear you. Put it up like this. Say, God is fighting for us. One more time. That was rehearsal. One more time. Say, God is fighting for us, pushing back the dark, lighting up the kingdom. Come on, make it louder. Make it louder. Jesus, enemies defeated. One more time, and we will shout it out. Come on, put me in A minor. A minor. Say,
God is fighting for us, pushing back the darkness, lighting up the kingdom that cannot be shaken. In the name of Jesus, enemies defeated.
Let the band play. Let the band play. Carol play. Come on and clap your hands. We'll be right back.
fighting for us. God is fighting for us. Pushing back the darkness. Lighting up the kingdom that cannot be shaken. In the name of Jesus.
Take it up.
And we will shout it out. Shout it out.
Come on, lift up a shout of praise to the Lord right there. Come on, lift up a shout of praise to the Lord because He's worthy. Hallelujah. Oh, yeah. Oh, yeah. I need to catch my breath. I'm out of shape. Haven't led worship in a while. Give me those little slow songs. Oh, man, isn't it good to be in the house of the Lord? Anybody, yeah. Woo. I'm just grateful for what I feel. I feel a victory in the house today. I feel like I'm around some people that have made up their mind that says my circumstances will not determine my praise. And let me just tell you, if you can just adopt that mindset, that you refuse to allow your circumstances to determine how deep you go into praise, I promise you, you will live in victory. You will live in victory. Amen. I'm just excited about this opportunity. If you've just gotten here, we've dedicated this service to worship and to prayer and to communion. And really what that means is that we don't know what we're doing here. We don't really know what we're going to do. We just like to create a space and just to see if He will come. And I know this, if I don't know anything, I know this, is that when we create a space for Him to come, He comes. He always comes. And usually the interruption of that happening is usually us. It's usually us. And just sit down for a second. Just sit down. You're going to stand up in a minute. I just want to encourage you with something real quick. I was encouraging, just keep playing, Tony, because I don't want them to think I'm preaching, because that would be weird if they just like, he tricked us. He said it was going to be worship, and now he's preaching. Now, I just want to encourage you with something that I was encouraging the worship team, and it just spoke to my heart. I think it spoke to theirs too. And there's just this scripture. You know, if David ever wrestled with what worship was in his life, if there's anybody that ever wrestled with really realizing what worship was, it was David. Bro was like troubled in his pursuit of the presence of God. You know, he had his moments where he was like, God, you're so far away from me. Why are you so far? Why are you staying so far off from me? And then the next moment, he goes, I will bless the Lord at all times. You know, and I've referenced this before, but I think that I always come back to his story. And I go back to his story because I relate as a worshiper. And let me just say, we all relate to that. We know what it's like to feel this, like, oh, I feel you so close, God. You're here. I feel you. And then it's like, you know, after lunch, it's like, where'd you go? And it's like worship is just like that kind of journey. And let me just tell you, if you're looking for some big punchline here, I'm just going to tell you that's really the way that worship is designed. It's designed to be that struggle. Because the minute that the struggle is over, that's probably mean you're no longer pursuing. And David writes this in Psalm 63:1, and I think you have it up there, Brooke. I want to just read this one scripture just to kind of set the atmosphere for the rest of the service. And it says this. It says, you, God, are my God. And earnestly I seek you. I thirst for you. My whole being longs for you. And then I'm like all with it. I'm with what he's saying. But then he goes, in a dry and parched land where there's no water. And it's like he has this this aha moment with God where he goes, you, God, are my God. And it's like he immediately goes, you, God, whoa, time out, God. You, God, are my God. It's like he reprioritizes his life in that moment. He goes, you, God, are my God, because I've apparently made some things my God. I've apparently have some idols that have gotten in the way. And he goes, you, God, are once again my priority. And he goes, I know you're my God. I know you're my daddy. I know that. But not only I know that you're my daddy, now I realize, aha, you're my number one. You're my number one priority. So I now can put the thing that was coming between you and me, the distraction at work, the crazy kids, the husband that's getting on your fat nerves right now. Yeah, there's nerves can be fat. I'm just saying they can be fat. Or you know, you're just struggling with your finances, or you're just struggling. And all of a sudden you have created space between God and you with the stuff. But David goes, you, God, ha. I get it. You're my God. And so he resets his priority. There's nothing that can come between us. I'm going to push through all of the circumstances. I'm going to push through all of the stuff to make sure that you're my God. And then he says this. He goes, I seek you and I thirst for you. My whole being longs for you. Then he says this, and this is the one that messed me up. In a dry and parched land where there's no water. Let me just tell you this. The dry season of your life is designed to push you back to him. See, we always are like, it's kind of like the chicken and the egg, like what comes first. It's like, if I could just get to the water, it helps the dryness. It's like, I'm just going to go around looking for water. If I could just, maybe I'll just hit that song. Maybe that one song would just be the thing that just opens it up. Or maybe it's, you know, if I could just, I'll go to church, and maybe that'll be I'll find the water. And we think it's the water that's waiting on us. But it's not the water that's waiting on us. It's us being so sick of the dryness that allows us to find the water. It's like, and you step into this room of worship with God, and you go, I'm going to find the door that's going to lead me to the water. And you become so desperate, and your dryness no longer irritates you, but it motivates you. You finally go, you know what? I feel like I'm just kind of going through the motions. You go, whoa, time out. I refuse to just go through the motions. I'm going to dig until I find some fresh water in my life. That's the whole key of worship. Just getting over the irritation of dryness and let it be a motivation to push you to the presence of God. That's worship 101 right there for your life. Instead of just being irritated, I dare you to just become motivated. Motivated to go, I don't know where you're at. But you, God, you're my God. And I will forever seek you. I'm not going to allow my circumstances to win anymore. I'm going to push all of the stuff that has come between you and me, and I'm going to find you because you're my God. That's the sermon today. And it's a sermon to position our hearts to a place to become desperate for him again. I speak that irritation of dryness to leave right now in the name of Jesus. And to then allow this supernatural motivation. There's people here, I look across the room, and I know some of your stories because I've prayed with you. I know what you've gone through over the past year. I know what you've lost. Some that have lost loved ones, many loved ones. Some have lost loved ones to COVID. People that are just like, okay, God, I'm going through the motions. But I'm praying that today in this service that you're going to have a you, God, are my God. And then all of the heaviness, all of the frustration, even all of the shaking your fist at God. God, if you would have been here. I get it. We've all done it. But it's all going to, you're going to reach a place of peace because you're going to find some water today. you're going to find some fresh water today. Today. If you're willing to set aside the irritation. So God, I pray over this service right now. At 10:40 on this last Sunday of the month of January 2022, God, we put an X on this date. We time stamp this moment because there's someone that's going to walk out of here free. People that have been dry, that just feels like, I don't even know why I'm going. I don't even know why I'm showing up. I don't know why I'm doing this. What is this all about? And I just, listen, that is about to be settled in your heart in the name of Jesus. I thank you, Father, right now. I invite your presence to come in this moment. And I welcome you here in this place. We speak the name of Jesus. The name of Jesus. And we welcome you here in this place. We thank you for your name that brings healing, your name that brings power, that brings deliverance, brings freedom. It's only in your name, in Jesus' name. Stand to your feet if you will. And I want to tell you, I don't want the pew to be your hindrance today. If you feel like you want to just walk around, if you want to come to the altar is open, you know, just feel the liberty just to worship with us for a few moments. We're not going to keep you here all day, but we're just going to make room for him, make a place for him, because we believe that the name of Jesus is wonderful. Isn't the name of Jesus wonderful? Isn't the name of Jesus powerful? Can we sing a new song over you as you just worship? Come on. Come on, lift your hands right now. Father, we worship you, Lord Jesus. Isn't the name of Jesus wonderful? Isn't the name of Jesus wonderful? And all the world can come to him and have their sins removed. Isn't the name of Jesus wonderful? Isn't the name of Jesus beautiful? Isn't the name of Jesus beautiful? The Son of God and one of us, the lover of my soul. Isn't the name of Jesus beautiful? Eternal King, you will reign forever, and we will see the glory of your name. Be lifted high for all the world to see. Your name is all we need. Your name is all we need.
Every knee must bow. Isn't the name
salvation in the name. There is life in the name. There is no other name but Jesus. Jesus, help me sing. There is freedom in the name. Sing it. Salvation in the name. There is life in the name. There is no other name but Jesus. Now that you know it, say there is freedom.
There is freedom in the name. Freedom in the name. There is power in the name.
Glory to you in the highest place.
whisper his name. Whisper his name.
Jesus.
Whisper his name.
Jesus.
And he will come to you. Yeah, yeah. The altars are open for you to whisper
Jesus.
His name. If you're broken in your spirit, whisper
Jesus.
His name. We're here to worship you. Lift your hands. Just worship God for a moment. Just a moment. Just forget the stage for a moment. Forget the stage for a moment and just step into your own room and just give him glory. If you need to change your posture, sometimes that helps. Sometimes if you just find your place on your knees, it just kind of breaks. It's designed to do that. You know, when you kind of just change your position, it just, something breaks in you. And just worship him wherever you're at. If you're at home, just worship him right where you're at. Heal the broken heart today, Lord Jesus. Heal the broken heart today, God. Yeah. Magnify your name, Jesus. Oh, Lord, we worship you.
Jesus, we worship you.